Welcome to this tutorial on how to create a mesh network using Aruba Access Points. These are the two Aruba Access Points I used in this video. In an Aruba Mesh network, one access point is used as the portal and the other access points are set as points. First, you connect the portal access point to your network using an Ethernet cable. The DHCP server allocates an IP address to the Aruba Access Point, so I use a software to scan the IP address. My goal is to create a mesh network in which access points create links with each other without the need for cables. There is only one portal access point that connects the cable to the router or switch. After finding the IP address of the portal access point, I opened any browser and accessed Aruba. The default username is admin. The default password is the device's serial number. You are required to create a new administrator password after first logging into the system. This password is used during operations and monitoring, so make sure it is strong enough. Next, you set the country and skip cloud settings. For Aruba Access Points, the control system is integrated into the firmware. Therefore, in a mesh network, you only need to configure the device selected as portal. Other access points will be synchronized with it. This approach of Aruba makes the system simpler and more flexible. On the access point portal, create a new wireless network. You enable fast roaming so your wireless network operates stably and seamlessly. While setting up fast roaming, you create an IDE so that the access points can be linked together. The newly created wireless network will automatically synchronize with the remaining access points in your network. Next, you set this access point as master. If you want to establish a wireless link between access points, you only need to connect an Ethernet cable to only this device. Other access points create links with each other and link to the portal access point without the need for cables. However, to ensure stability, you can use cables to connect to access points. Cable connections do not affect your mesh configuration. Once completed, you will be asked to restart the access point to apply the settings. Above are the basic configuration steps on the access point master. Next, you connect another access point to your network system. Before creating a cableless connection, use an Ethernet cable to connect the other access point to your switch or router. Aruba's control system will automatically scan devices in your network and synchronize configurations from the access point master to the remaining devices. After you ensure the system has discovered all access points, you go to the step of setting up the mesh network. You go to Advanced Settings in System. Here you disable extended SSID. Now your wireless network will become a mesh wireless network. You restart all access points so they can create links with each other. It will take about 10 to 15 minutes to complete creating the links. Subsequent access points you add to the system will act as points. I disconnected the cable from the second access point to test its link with the main access point. After a while of waiting, it was linked to the master access point. So I have completed creating a new mesh network using Aruba Access Point. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I recommend that you set up a static IP address for the master access point, because the configurations are mainly done on it and you won't want to find its IP address every time you want to access the control system. And finally, I use a Windows computer connected to the mesh network I just created. On the Aruba control system, you not only have configuration but also a monitoring system and more. Good luck.